బ్రహ్మాదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశర్షభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటి శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బెస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షం టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. We will begin Bhagavad-gita, verse number 40 of 6th chapter. Shri Bhagavan uvacha partha naiveha namutra vinashastasya vidyate nahi kalyana krut kaschit durgatim tata gacchati. There are three kinds of hurdles, obstructions are introduced in the beginning itself by our Shastra. Shastra does everything in perfect way. It discusses about the destination properly. It also discusses about the sadhaka, who is the student of Vedanta, the qualifications, whatever is required. It talks about the qualifications of the guru, and it also talks about how the guru has to teach the methodology and the destination, everything clearly told. And also whatever the doubts which will arise during the teaching, that also cleared. Not only that, all kinds of obstructions have been derived as a threefolded obstructions. Adhyatmika dukkham, adhyatmika badhah. So these all obstructions have been named as adhyatmika, adibhautika, adidaivika. Adhyatmika means the obstruction that which comes from his own body, mind and sense complex. For example, Jada Bharata. This Jada Bharata Murati, who loved his dear very much. In the next janma, he became dear itself. He had the deer with the dearness, therefore he had become deer itself. He deviated yoga chalitamanasaha, or Krishna names yoga bhrashtaha. He became deer itself. And there was one person called Trishanku. He wanted to reach the swarga with the physical body itself. He made lots of effort. Even Vishwamitra helped him to have the separate swarga. He was not able to reach swarga, therefore Vishwamitra helped him to have a Trishanku swarga, separate swarga. But Vishwamitra lost all the tapas phalani. All the benefit that which he received by having tapas, he lost and he had to regain again. So like there are so many examples. In between, if a person goes some hurdles, not able to practice properly, then the next varieties of obstruction are the bhautikam, because of the family commitments, because of some people around you, and there are one more called adidaivikam, by the natural force. All this tsunami, earthquake, volcano eruption, even the storm, this kind of natural disaster can be also a kind of obstruction for the spiritual path. So whatever the obstruction took place, he died or whatever it is. Once he began, no nashtaha. Durgatim tata nagachati. He is named by Krishna, is known as Kalyanakrita. Kalyana means Mangalam. He becomes Kalyanakarta, Mangalakarta, because Vedanta is so auspicious. This path of single bit or every step of this path is nothing but auspicious, very much auspicious alone. Iha amutra tasya vinashaha na vidyate. Even on the earth, hereafter, he never gets durgati vinashaha. He is not destroyed. He cannot be destroyed. Because he is a karta of mangalam, kalyanakrita. He won't reach adhogati. He will never. So big assurance. Then he continues. Prapya punyakritan lokan ushetva shashvati samahat. Shuchinam shrimatam gehe yoga bhashto bhijayate. So there is no destruction for him. He cannot be destroyed by any force because he is Mangalakarta. And what he would get as the benefit? He will get punyam. Prapya punyam. Punyam prapya. Then what? So he will reach the heaven like the lokas, the worlds hereafter. There he will live a long life with happiness. Because this Vedanta considered as the punya phalam is. Bhashyakara even says, so 1 minute study of Vedanta is equal to perform thousands of yajnas together. That big yajnas, Vajabeya, Ashwamedha, Vishwajit yajnas together. 1 minute study of Vedanta. And that is as equal to give all the earth in dana. Because when you give dana, you will gain lots of punya. This is as equal to earth itself to dana to somebody. So how big deal it is? It is impossible by even the followers of Karmakanda. Not only that, all Pitrus and the Rishis worshipped for thousands of Janma. Whatever you get the fruit out of it, you will gain by attending 1 minute of Vedantic studies. So powerful, so useful. He will reach definitely to the great lokas and he will become Shashvati hi Samaha. Then the next birth also he will have. That Shuchinam Shrimatam Gehe. Cultured and wealthy people's house. He will be born again. He will be born in the cultured, wealthy people. That is very important. Two kinds of explanation. Krishna would have been aware about all the wealthy people, because nowadays wealthy people means all black and white, white and black. Oh my God, it's a big samsara. Therefore, wealthy, that to cultured people. This yoga bhashtaha, the person who is not able to succeed in the yoga marga, he will definitely will be born again in the wealthy, healthy people's house. It means what? He will have a joyful life over there. But one more question. What will happen that study? If I had completed 5 chapters of Bhagavad Gita, if I be reborn again, then will I start from the beginning or should I continue from the 7th chapter? That's what he says. Athava yoginameva kule bhavati dhimatam etadhi dullabhataram loke janma itidrisham. And also he gives one more condition. Either he will be born in a wealthy, healthy people's house or he will be born among the yogis, means sadhakas alone. There won't be money, but sadhanas are kept given priority. It's very rare loke yati idrisham yadi idrishataram idrisham loke yadi idrisham durlabhataram. It's very rare to be born like that. You know, Lord Bhagavan Ramana is an example. Sant Jnaneshwar is an example. So many rishis are example. Sukha Maharishi in Puranic time is example. From the birth itself, they are yogis. Yogi Nam, they will be born where the old studies are given important. In that place, he will be born. Then he will continue from there.
Tatra tam buddhi samyogam labhate paurva dehikam yatate chatato bhuyaha samsiddhau kuru nandana.
From being that house, either in the wealthy, healthy people's house or in yogi's house, he will continue the study which was left here. He will begin from there. Tatra buddhi sanyogam labhate. So you should be aware, as I told you, the parents only give birth to physical system, not for the psychological system. The psychological system is being brought from the last birth. So our mind carries all the vasanas to the next birth. Therefore, always be endowed with good vasana. You become the sufferer. If you are endowed with bad deeds right now, so you are going to be sufferer, because you will carry them. All other people who are becoming partner during this evil deeds, they will go in their own way. You will be taken on the head to experience. So body to body you will carry. Therefore, don't create poisonating any kind of karma phala. Now, though they are born in the wealthy, healthy people's house with lots of wealth and lots of cultural things, but they will continue as a Vedantic student. You know, we need not to worry about it. When you study Bhagavad Gita, it is as equal to commit all kinds of kumbhavishayaka, yajna, yaga, homa, dana, dharma. Everything is together known as Vedantic study. You will get connected again now. It is not like that you dropped in the next birth. You have to go from the preliminary, means elementary school. Because that vidya cannot give this much fruit. This fruit which we get from this vidya, it can be carried to the next janmas. How wonder it is. It's a beautiful wonder. My God, this fruit, nowhere it is defined like that. Tatra buddhi samyogam tam labhate. There, wherever he is born, even in the yogi's house or a wealthy, healthy people's house, he will be connected with the same buddhi, same understanding. From there, he will travel ahead. Paurva dehikam, that was connected with the elderly, early body. Yatate cha tato bhuyaha sam siddhau kuru nandana. Okay, now when Krishna says like this, we will become with a sigh of birth. My God. Because every one of us, we confirm ourselves, it's not going to be in this birth. Because endowed with so many raga dvesha, because we have studied in different way, we were penetrated by so many other kind of knowledge. In order to remove that knowledge is impossible. I mean, so all the samskaras which was there, which is there inside, all of them are bothering us, bugging us. We are not able to remove them. We are trained to be endowed with this deadly world. Our mind is to be relived with the Vedantic thoughts. For that alone, Abhyasa and Vairagya were suggested by Lord Krishna. He continues, Purva Abhyasena Tenaiva Hriyate Hyavashopisaha జిజ్ఞాసురపి యోగస్య శబ్ద బ్రహ్మాత్ వర్తతే. హీ కంటిన్యూస్ యాజ్ ద యోగి, యాజ్ ద స్టూడెంట్ ఇన్ హిస్ లైఫ్. ఇట్స్ అ బిగ్ డీల్. వెన్ యు ఆర్ బోర్న్, యు నీడ్ నాట్ టు బిగిన్ ఫ్రమ్ ద స్క్రాచ్. యూ విల్ జస్ట్ యు నో కంటిన్యూ యాజ్ పూర్వాభ్యాస్ ఇన్ దిస్. అభ్యాస్ ఆల్సో విల్ ట్రావెల్ విత్ యూ, ద నాలెడ్జ్ ఆల్సో విల్ ట్రావెల్ విత్ యూ, దాట్ ఆల్సో ఎఫర్ట్లెస్లీ. జిజ్ఞాసు అపి యోగస్య శబ్ద బ్రహ్మాతి వర్తతే. సో జిజ్ఞాసురపి యోగస్య స్వరూపం జ్ఞాతుం ఇచ్చన్ యోగమార్గే ప్రవృత్త సన్యాసి యోగభ్రష్ట సామర్థ్యాత్ సహాపి శబ్దబ్రహ్మ వేదోక్త కర్మానుష్ఠాన ఫలం అతివర్తతే అపాకరిష్యతే కిముత బుద్ధ యో యోగం తన్నిష్ట అభ్యాసం కుర్యాత్. ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఇస్ క్యారీడ్ ఫర్ దేర్. అన్నోయింగ్లీ హీ విల్ బీ అకంపనీడ్. యు మైట్ హ్యావ్ సీన్ because this is a clear cut understanding by our shastra. In your life, you just think about your young age. Something made to select the education you underwent, and some instinct from outside or inside felt you to select your life partner. So everything, you know, they are in an order. That order you may not, you might have not noticed. You just sit in a place, you think about from the birth what and all happened. After you were born, what kind of changes happened in your family and how you were brought up. Everything is because of your karmapala. You have been carrying from the last birth. Now you can found, because sometimes I have seen the person, one of my friend, he was born in a very poor family, but well trained physic and memory. My God, that memory, he could by heart within 2 days whole Bhagavad Gita. Not only that, he could by heart all the Upanishad, even Ramayana, Mahabharata with all verses. So those poor family, they were not able to feed him properly, but he could get that much talented. Now he has become a big vakta, a public speaker. So like that, something we are carrying, some talent. Though the environment not there, we created ourselves. Because we digged from the last birth. Now you could see the people, whoever in the young age itself are well versed in Vedanta, they were yoga bhrashtas. Yoga bhrashtas means what? They were from the last birth itself, they are carrying their all sadhanas. It's a big deal. So because you have to have a proper understanding about your life. Purvabhyasena means we are not aware about past birth. Doesn't matter. But whatever seshaha remaining, we have been carrying from the birth. Now you could find the talent which you are bringing from the last birth. It comes effortlessly. Somebody can sing well. Somebody can paint well. Somebody can plan well. So these all talents we are bringing from the last birth. In the same way, this person, he brings. And also what? The guru will take place. Vedanta will come to you. Everything will take place. It's not that you will be, you know, bringing from your brain alone. The environment will take place. And even Adi Shankara and Ramanuja, Madhva, all of them are like that. From the childhood, they were given a proper education because I think they were yoga bhrashta. Otherwise, in the childhood, it's impossible. then all the nine words, arvars, they are also like that. Some of them from young age itself, they were yogis. Now you could understand, oh my God, you know, all the variations among the people, how it is to be understood.
Shabda brahmati vartate means Vedokta karmanutthana phalam ati vartate abhakarishyati kimuta buddha yo yogam tannishthaha abhyasam kuryad.
Therefore this yoga never gives failure. That has to be the understanding. The next words.
Prayatnat yataman astu yogi samshuddha kilbishaha aneka janma samsiddhaha tato yati param gatim.
A person who could make effort, a proper effort, prayatnat yataman astu yogi, he is known as yogi, not yoga bhrashtaha. This person samshuddha kilbishaha, he destroys all kinds of evil deeds in his life, and that is also supported not only from this birth, from so many births he might have been making effort, abhyasa and vairagya aneka janma samsiddha tataha param gatim yati, he reaches the moksha, definitely no failure. Or we can take the person who is born, he was yoga brashta in the previous life, but he could continue with the prayatna in this life, anayasene, effortlessly he could continue in this life. Okay, now in the next words, Bhagavan Krishna gives certain explanation about yogi and jnani. Then karma bhyaha, the karma kandi, the performer of action.
Tapas vibhyo dhiko yogi jnani bhyo pimato dhikaha karma bhyascha dhiko yogi tasmad yogi bhavarjuna.
The yogi is greater than tapasvi. Even he is greater than jnani. He is greater than karmi or karmakandi. Therefore, you become yogi. These verses are very complicated one. Because he wants to emphasize the yogi tvam, giving priority for vairagya and abhyasa. Yogi means who is settled with vairagya and abhyasa. And that too Vedantic way. We should not forget, there is all for the person who is endowed with Vedantic study. From the first chapter to sixth chapter, whoever studies, for him alone everything is told here. Therefore, when you study Bhagavad Gita, you have to be very confident, no failure. And also, you should be very thorough about every classes, every verses. Sometimes, you know, we get bored. That is adhyatmika obstructions. You have to be careful. You have to make yourself pakka with every class. Never fail. Because the knowledge which can travel with you to Janma means it's a miracle. And one may have the question, Swamiji, even you know our bad deeds and good deeds also travels with us. Yes, of course, that's what I say. The bad deed and good deeds will travel with us, but this yogitva practice, even though you left home, left all karmas, just you are sticking with jnana yoga, but if you are not able to get it, then also you are not failure. You have to know that point. There you should perform. If you stop yajna in between, you won't get the yajna phala. If you stop japa in between, you will get a semi amount of phala. But here you will get 100% what you have done, you can carry to the next life. It's a great boon, isn't it? and that too as a yogi. To be a yogi, you should be backed up by all the knowledge which were given in the past life. Now you can list all the jnanis, yogis, and from Purana and Itihasa. All people, certain characters you might have seen like Narada, Durvasa Maharshi, even Hanuman. The Hanuman was a karma yogi. He was in the Ramayana, even you could see him in Mahabharata. We call it a Siranjeevi. These characters were not imaginative characters. Many people, they don't believe the Puranic characters, the characters we find in Itihasa. They are not imaginative characters. The real characters, they are alone the real characters in this world. So that much the stuff our Sanatana Dharma in which we are born has. We have to be thankful to every rishis, every circumstances, environment. To be born in India, it is, you know, very fortunate people. I have seen so many foreigners, they crave for it. So one of my students who married in India, in India means who brought the girl also from foreign country, and who married in India, and he wanted a child to be born in India. I think in Kashi the child was born. They know that much importance about our nation. Our people, unfortunately, not being informed our own scriptures. We have to be aware, or we have to become aware. And also we should make awareness in all the people, particularly to all the youngsters. These all fruits are magic, miracles, wonders, and marvelous. And when we study this little bit with efforts and more understanding. So my mind, I always like, you know, teach in simple way. Sometimes I make very simple, sometimes I may not able to present it in simple way. Still, I have my own effort to bring it in simple way so that people could digest our scriptures. That too with a colloquial language. That's what my effort is. And may Lord Krishna and Lord Balaji will bless us to continue the education, means the study, and to digest everything. And also bestow to get all kinds of Abhyasa Vairagya Siddhi. We'll see you in next episode. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.